Hello, friends. I am Rolando Lucas, Evangelist Rolando Lucas, bringing you the little message of today. Today, I'll be preaching to you from the book of Jonah, the prophet, on the chapter 1 and chapter 2. I'm just going to quote a few verses from each, but I'm going to title this message, The Prayer of the Quarantine Prophet. The Prayer of the Quarantine Prophet. Let's go to the Bible, if you have a Bible. I got one here, but I got the font bigger on my screen. And I'm going to go to chapter 1, verse 17. So follow me to Jonah, chapter 1, verse 17. And then we're going to go to chapter 2, verse 1 and 2, and then verse 7. So the Bible says in Jonah, chapter 1, verse 17, Now the Lord has prepared a great fish to swallow up Jonah. And Jonah was in the belly of the fish 3 days and 3 nights. Remember that. 3 days and 3 nights. Chapter 2. We're going to move to chapter 2, verse 1 and verse 2. The Bible says in chapter 2, verse 1, Then Jonah prayed unto the Lord, his God, out of the fish belly. Verse 2, And said, I cry by reason of mine affliction unto the Lord, and he heard me. Out of the belly of hell, cried I, and thou heardest my voice. Now let's go to verse number 7. Verse 7 says, When my soul fainted within me, I remember the Lord. Remember the Lord. When it's the hardest time in your life, whenever you're going through difficulty, whenever we're going through like this pandemic now, whenever this time of trial and tribulation, do like the prophet, remember the Lord in prayer. And my prayer came in to thee unto thy holy temple. That's the completion of chapter 1, verse 17, and chapter 2, verses 1, 2, and 7. Now, I'm going to pray and give you the little message. Father, we thank you, Lord, for your blessing. Thank you for this story that teaches how to pray in time of difficulty, Lord. We can learn from this prophet, Lord, that we must obey, Lord, because if we don't obey you, Lord, you allow us to go to trial and tribulation. Lord, I pray that this be a blessing to somebody on the other side of the screen. I pray that somebody that doesn't know Jesus as a personal Savior, that person make that decision today. We thank you in Jesus' holy name. Amen. Amen, brother. Let me go because I got 6 points. I'm going to give you as many as I can. It's hard to preach 15 minutes and tell you everything that you want, that I wanted to say. I'm just going to be limited and try to give you as much as I can. But by the way, introduction, Jonah was in quarantine by God. 3 days and 3 days. In quarantine, like it means in a simple medical term, isolation for a period of time. That's what it means. Isolation for a period of time. He spent 3 days, 3 nights on the belly of the whale. Why? Because it's disobedience. Disobedience. God told him to go to Nineveh and preach to those people that in 40 days God was going to bring judgment to them. But instead of obeying God, he decided to take a ship and go to Tarshish or another city and disobey God. And God created a big old storm, and the ship was in trouble, and all the mariners were afraid, the captain. So they found out what was the reason of the problem. He was down there sleeping, and the captain talked to him, why is the reason of this problem? So they prayed to their gods and whatever it may be. After he realized that he was the problem, he threw him aboard to the water, and that's why he spent, he went to the belly of the whale. 3 days and 3 nights, just to a little bit of what happened to, I could tell you I love with more time, but from the Bible, but this is what happened. He disobeyed God. And because of this disobedience, he spent 3 days, 3 nights in quarantine or in isolation because of his disobedience. God gave him an instruction to preach to those wicked people in Nineveh, and he disobeyed. And this time, he learned something. He learned to pray. He learned to pray to God, invoke the name of the Lord, because we see it on these verses, how he communicated with God. Number one, he had an emergency prayer, anguish prayer. And we can see that in verse number 2 of chapter 2. Bible says in verse number 2 of chapter 2, I cry by reason of my affliction. He was in trouble. He was in anguish. He has pain in his heart. Unto the Lord, I cry by reason of mine affliction unto the Lord, and he heard me. That's a good thing that when we pray to the Lord, he hears our prayers. And in verse continues saying, out of the belly of hell cried I, and thou heardest my voice. Thank you, God, that you can hear our prayers in difficult times like this. I mean, we are praying for a lot of people. People of Fayegan School, public school, the sick with this C-19 virus. And I'm praying for them, and people are praying for them. I'm praying that they come out of this faster and stronger than ever. And with trusting in God, Lord, because I know there's a lot of people praying for that. But when a pandemic began, we heard a lot of people crying out and shouting. Especially in the United States, you remember when people came out with that. There's no toilet paper. And there was empty. All the supermarkets were empty of toilet paper. And the Philippines, they had no, they cried out. They didn't have no alcohol. In the whole world, we had nothing to eat. We had no food. And Christians were saying, we have no church. We have no companionship. But you know something? What we learned about this quarantine? We learned how to pray in times like this. We learn how to pray in difficult times. Like, that's something we are doing. We have messages preached by all over the United States on Facebook and other internet places. I mean, that we hear preaching. We've been watching 3, 4, 5 messages a day. We have an opportunity to listen to the Word of God and pray and spend time in prayer. Number two, it was a prayer of learning that the prophet, he learned. Verse 4, look at what the Bible says in verse 4, then in chapter 2. Then I say, I am cast out of thy sight, yet I will look again towards thy holy temple. Amen. He learned the importance of obeying God. You know that 3 days and 3 nights teach you a good lesson. Amen. Especially in the belly of the whale. Number 3, it was a prayer of dependent upon God. And I'm going to spend a little time in this. Look at what verse number 7. Let me take you to verse number 7. It said, when my soul fainted, he said, within me, I remembered the Lord. And my prayer came into thee, into thy holy temple. We need to depend on God, people. We can depend on ourselves. We cannot depend on the government. Don't put the trust in the government. You cannot put the trust on the media telling you the truth. You must put your trust in the Lord. Him and his holy word is what you need. This is what the source. This is what you need to put your trust in. Because the world, even doctors, even scientists are confused on how to deal with this pandemic. But you know, if you put your, or you pray, you depend yourself in the Lord, you are going to have the best advice. You listen to the Word of God preach. You get the best advice from the Word of God. That's what we need. He said, when I saw my soul fainted within me, I remembered the Lord. That's the one we got to learn to call on when we need the strength in our that we are weak and we are in trouble and we are worried and we are depressed. God is the only one who can give you the strength to keep on going. Amen. In times of difficulty and time of uncertainty, learn to depend on the Lord. Number 4, the prophet says, it was a prayer of gratitude. Now, I mean, to say that it was a prayer of gratitude. Look at verse number 9 in chapter 2. The verse says, but I will sacrifice unto thee with the voice of thanksgiving. But I will sacrifice unto thee with the voice of thanksgiving. You know, we ought to be thankful. We are thankful for what we have. We are to be thankful for what we don't have. And blessed be the name of the Lord. That's what we need to say every morning. We have to be thankful because we live in America. If you try this, try to go somewhere in Afghanistan, somewhere in Africa, you're going to learn to be thankful if you go to places like that where you can find nothing to eat. But you know, you ought to be thankful that you live in the United States and you have food to eat. Look, I'm probably gained about 10 pounds. I'm blessed by the best, I'm telling you. But we need to learn as Christians to have gratitude, to thank God for what we have. Thank God for what we don't have, because we are blessed by the best. That's point number five. It was a prayer of commitment. Look at chapter 2, verse 9. The second part of the chapter says, I will pay that I have vowed. You know, when we make promises to God, when we tell God that we're going to do this and we're going to surrender ourselves to do something, to serve on any ministry or to do something for the Lord, we ought to do it. God is expecting us to do it. I mean, you ought to surrender your life to God, because that's the only thing we have. That He's the only one who can give you what we need. He can provide, and you have assurance of that you are going to get the best of it, because it's God is going to give it to you. But you need to commitment to serve the Lord and be faithful in everything He asks you to do. Amen. Let's keep on going. Number six. It was a recognizing prayer, recognizing God in his prayer. He was recognizing God. He says in the verse number 9, the third part of the verse, right at the end, salvation is of the Lord. And that, with that said, I will say the same thing. Salvation is of the Lord. You know, the only way that you can be able to enter heaven, the kingdom of heaven, is by trusting Jesus as your personal Savior. You cannot enter heaven just by being a nice person, just to be a religious person, just to be baptized or sprinkle water over your head, or because your relative is saved. It's by salvation. And God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish but have everlasting life. He gave us the biggest gift that you can get in life, salvation. By grace, through faith. And that is not of yourself. It's the gift of God. Not by works. You know, because a lot of people be boasting. They give money and they do works of kindness and stuff like that. That is good after you are saved. But you must trust Jesus as your personal Savior. My question is to you. Have you trusted Jesus as your personal Savior for salvation? The Bible said, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. That's Romans 3:23. As it's written, there's not righteous, not one. Romans 3:10. But God commanded His love towards us. While we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. That's Romans 5:8. If thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God has raised Him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. That's Romans 10:9. You can ask Him to save you today for salvation, because salvation is of the Lord. And I ask you, this humble preacher is just telling you, it's not a great message. I don't have enough time to give you a good, you know, I take my time taking and explaining and giving illustration. I have 15 minutes and try to make the best of it. But this is the best and most important part. This is the meaning. Part of the message is that you out there on the other side can trust Jesus and your personal Savior. And my question is, are you 100% sure that if you go on that, if you die today, which, you know, you're going to die, are you 100% sure you're going to heaven? That's the question that I'm asking you. Prophet said, salvation is of the Lord. I'm going to be finishing in a moment. I'm going to review the points that I give you. But you have an opportunity to trust Jesus as your personal Savior. First, the prophet, because of disobedience, 3 days and three nights on the belly of the whale, had an emergency prayer. He had plenty of time, 3 days and three nights, to pray. He had nothing else to do. Number two, it was a prayer of learning to obey, because he disobeyed. He disobeyed God's commandment to go preach to the people of Nineveh. Number three was a prayer dependent on God. We must learn to depend on God. We cannot do it by ourselves. We must depend on God. That was number 3 point. Number four, it was a prayer of gratitude. We must be thankful for what we have and what we don't have. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Number five was a prayer of commitment. Commit thyself into the Lord, and He will give you the desires of your heart. Commit yourself. be in the middle of His will. That's what we need to do. Be in the middle of His will. And second, and the last one, six, he recognized God. He recognized God in prayer. Salvation is of the Lord. Now, I'm going to pray and I finish this message. I'm going to pray because our time is up. It's 15 minutes already. And I'm going to give you an invitation. If you want to pray with me, follow after me. After it's not the word. It's just the heart behind the word. Father, thank you, Lord, for this message. What a blessing it is. Lord, we can learn from this prophet how to learn to pray, Lord. And Lord, in times like this, in times of difficulty, Lord, I pray and thank for that. I depend on you. I wake up in the morning and I thank you for what I have and what I don't have. Lord, I pray that somebody on the other side can pray this prayer with me for salvation. Say with me, dear God, I know I am a sinner. I believe that Jesus died on the cross to pay for my sin, was crucified, buried, died, buried, and resurrected, shed His precious blood for me. I ask you, God, to forgive me of my sins. This moment, I trust Jesus as my personal Savior. And thank you, God, for saving me. In His name, amen. Simple prayer like that. You know what I mean? It's not the words. It's what is in your heart. God knows if you mean what you said. And that's what really matters. I mean, you die of COVID-19, you die of cancer, you die of anything. It don't matter. You're going to die one day. But you have this assurance that you heard of today and you pray that prayer that you are going to heaven when you die. Thank you. And remember, this is Evangelist Rolando Lucas Ayala, and you are blessed by the bed. Leave me, please, a comment, a prayer request, whatever you may need. I'm going to leave you a comment where you can contact me. What a blessing. Remember, you are blessed by the best. Adios.